Morning, good evening, good afternoon, everybody. This is a very easy stretch routine, all on the floor, all nice and easy. You can do that after a busy day or after a busy workout. Let's get started. You want to grab a mat or a soft floor and simply start with lying on your back. You want to stretch the left leg and then pull the right leg towards you. You want to keep the shoulders down, keep the head straight, and you can push into your heel with the left leg. This is a good psoas stretch, hip flexor. And try to really breathe slowly. Exhale and pull the knee a little bit closer. Very nice. We're holding for about 20 seconds. Then release. You want to bring the knee in and then stretch this leg. Oh, I've been working out my hamstrings. I feel it. So again, you want to push into the heel. It doesn't matter how far away the leg is from your chest. Just keep your chest relaxed on the floor. And you don't even have to pull the leg. Sometimes it's enough to just really elongate into the heel and into the sitting bone. It's a good stretch already. And then you might want to, I don't know if you can see it, turn your foot in and out and see where it's tightest. Mine is tightest when I turn the leg out. And then I really feel a deep pull in the back of my thigh. Very nice. Come back. Put your ankle on the knee and then try to just bring this right knee a little bit to the outside. And that might be enough already. Or you want to pick up the leg. Good belly workout at the same time. This foot can just relax. Now, if this is not enough, if you're one of those bendy people, then you can grab your thigh and see if you can still relax without like tearing your gluteus. This is a good piriformis, deep hip rotator stretch. And there might be some people who are able to grab the front of the shin bone, which I can't really, or it would not be so relaxing. So just go whatever level you are. And then slowly release. Hope this leg is still fully functional. Then just relax left leg. Grab your right knee with the left hand from the outside. You want to bring the right arm to the side. The inside of the hand, palm facing up. And rotate. This is one of my favorite ones. And exhale into the stretch. And you do want to make this a really nice and soft one, so don't really press it down. You need to touch the floor. I always prefer to keep this shoulder on the floor rather than having the knee on the other side of the floor, because then you're really making sure that you're twisting other than just, you know, rotating. So this arm gives you a nice fixed point. So you keep the shoulder on the floor. Very nice. Then come back. Perfect. Switch sides. So we're going to start by bringing the right leg out. Push into the heel. Try to elongate this leg. And this leg can probably relax as much as possible. And exhale, bring the knee closer to the chest. Don't bring the chest to the knee. Try to relax the head, the shoulders. You're breathing as much as possible. Exhale again. Try to bring the knee a bit closer without dislocating your hip. Always be gentle with your body. You might want to try to push into that right heel a little bit more. Feeling good. And release. Then bring the right leg up and we want to push to the ceiling. So try to push the ceiling away. but stay on the floor with your sit bone as much as possible on your left leg. So you can just stay here. So if you had a tray on your foot, or you grab your thigh, still trying to really relax the shoulders. You do want to have a long neck, no strain on the upper body, so we can focus on pushing this heel out a little bit further. And remember, you might want to turn the leg in and out. Ooh, and again, knee turning out. Ooh, that is a nice pull. All right, very good. Then bend the knee, bring the ankle on top of the other knee, still totally relaxed in the upper body. Now the left knee goes out a bit, and this might already be enough of a stretch, or you pick the leg up, both ones. Just make sure you're not ending in something like this. You do want to have a nice opening here in the knee. It's also good to sit like this. If you're one of these people who always crosses their legs, a good alternative is to bring the ankle on the knee. Of course, it depends in which situation you can do that. It doesn't look very ladylike, but well, if nobody sees it and you just need to somehow cross your legs, then this is a good alternative. All right. About 20 seconds. Try to always do the same variation left and right so you're not getting disbalanced. Now, relax the right leg, grab left with the right hand, the other side, one and a half space, and bring the left arm to the side. Keep the shoulder down and then exhale and rotate. You might want to bring the head to the other hand. I'm not doing this because then you can't hear me, I guess, or can you? So this is a nice rotation for the whole spine, but still try to keep the left shoulder on the floor. An exhalation reduces the tonus of our muscles, and guess what? When we stretch, we better have reduced tonus of our muscles. So if they're too tight, then of course we shouldn't actually stretch. Then we might even create little tears and even, you know, break tissue, which we don't want. So always relax when you're stretching. Come back up. And now the last one, the front of the thigh, is lining your side. And now grab your ankle. This is a position we all know from standing, but this time we do it lying. If you do want more stability, you just bend the lower leg. And now bring the hip forward, contract the glutes a little bit, and bring the hip forward. You don't want this knee to go up, up, up. You do want to have it more or less parallel to the floor. Now make this a really easy stretch for the quadriceps, and you can also try to play a little bit here with rotation, because there's four strains if you want, so that's why it's called quadriceps, and they all have their own way of getting stretched in that area. Alright, nice and easy. Now if you want to, you can just roll onto the other side. I'm going to repeat the same thing, always healing out left and right. Or you can do as I did, swing around. Now I always put this leg on, this is my leg, put this arm on the floor and rest my head on my arm, so my cervical spine, my neck is kind of the in line with my spine. So you can do like this or like this. All right, right leg, or just the other one. Again, the leg on the floor can be bent. Now press the hip forward a little bit, contract the bum, and bring this thigh parallel to the floor. If you want to, you can start rotating a little bit. Again, for me, outside rotation is the worst. So the word is worst, that's already the superlative, no? All right. And push the hip forward a little more. Exhale, try to relax. And we're done stretching our legs. Well done. Thanks for supporting and subscribing. If you haven't, give me a thumbs up so I know you liked it. And if you want to tell me more, then you can comment below, like, what's next? Or what have you been up to? And I hope to see you soon. Bye.